In this video, I'm going to show you guys how my wife and I customized this walk-in closet for a special surprise in behind these doors. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. I'm Kody with Up to Kode. If you like the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and let's jump into it. What my wife and I had to do is we had to mix the IKEA Pax closet system with the IKEA Sektion system, which is designed for their kitchens. And the reason we did that is because we wanted to get main floor laundry in our walk-in closet. So we'll show you how we got to this, but we had to start with the Pax system. So when you go on the IKEA planner, you can plan your Pax system or your kitchen. I already knew what the kitchen dimensions were that I needed. So we've had to figure out, okay, we started with this Pax corner unit. It utilizes good space. I can get to the inside corner. It's got a nice little shoe rack down there. That establishes a known dimension because it fits in the corner. After that, 100 centimeter Pax unit. You can configure it any way you want. We just did lots of drawers, shelf, one row of clothes. Here's a 50 centimeter. Now keep in mind, I know it's gonna be messy, but throughout the video, I'm probably gonna mix between metric and imperial. So this is metric, 50 centimeter. Again, drawers, a little shallow jewelry one, and shelving again. Then over here, we jumped into another 50 centimeter with the frosted glass doors. Little bit different configuration, couple drawers, couple baskets, and some shelves. And then once that was all set in stone, then I could actually make room for this laundry unit. So inside, the washer and dryer are 24 inches wide, 24 inches deep. What I did is actually bought two. These are fridge panels, 36 by 96 inch for Batra off-white panels for your kitchen. So I bought two of those. I have Grimsloft off-white doors, and basically it's from a pantry unit that's 90 inches tall, 30 inches wide, and I knew that they had the doors that would work with that. So this is a 15 inch wide, 40 inch tall Grimsloft door, 50 inch tall, and again, just the same thing. It's designed for a pantry unit. And what I did is I just put the brackets on just to make it as one, and it's just easier to open and close. So that's what I bought to get that part finished. So once I had this set, I went from the height of my Pax unit and I just customized and cut these panels to match the top height. I knew my doors would still work. I just have a little lower toe kick than I normally would for a kitchen because the Pax system is slightly different dimension than the kitchen. But it still works. And then the depth, what I did there is I just went 30 inches deep because the last time my wife and I did this, it was just like an inch too narrow. And I'll show you why you want that extra depth. A, the last one, it was so tight I couldn't actually get in behind to pop the hinges off. And again, down here, I have this little toe kick that allows the door to back up onto something, and it's got L-tie brackets or little L brackets that I can remove and slide that out so I can pull the washer and dryer out and service it. So you can tell I need a little bit of room for that, and I need room for the hinges, so that's why the extra depth. Plus you have the cord and the vent and everything in behind that you need some space for. Yeah, so I have a backing there, and I also have a backing at the very top, which so my doors just sit nicely, they don't fall in inward. Yeah, and it also gives me that true 30 inch dimension because the 30 inches is outside to outside, just the exact same as a cabinet box would be. Later, after I explain this, I'll show you, I took some photos and I'll explain how I got the spacings for the hinges. And then finally, that helps hold this gable panel is another Pax unit, 50 centimeter. It just gives me stability, and we set it back just so that it's doesn't crowd the room and around the corner from the door. Yeah, so that's it. I'll show you how I laid out the hinges and kind of the some of the code, product code numbers on the doors and the panels. So we'll do that right now.
Here's what it looked like beforehand. I pre-planned my duct work so it would fit inside of a 2x8 wall. I insulated it and pre-planned it all. Boarded it up, looks nice and tidy. Did some mudding and taping. And then obviously had to set the cabinetry and the panels and everything. And now it's at a stage where I'm ready to install the doors and also lay out my hinge locations. Here's the 40-inch Grimsloft doors that I used. So I just took photos of those so you guys had an example and part numbers. Here's the 50-inch door. And then here's those kitchen panels, those Verbatra 36x96-inch kitchen panels that we used. Now what I did is I laid the doors out exactly how I wanted them with the right gapping and spacing and everything, and I measured out my hinge locations. And I just wanted to confirm that I was starting at the right dimension. So I was 2.5 inches to the center of the hinge on the door. I took a box out and I also verified that that second hole location is 2.5 inches, which it is. And this is an example of it in another kitchen setup. Then I had to verify the back set from the front of the cabinet back, those hole locations. So I've laid it all out. I marked out all my measurements and I made a storyboard. So I made this on a little piece of cardboard. I knew all my dimensions from the top down. I laid them all out. So I laid from top down and then from the front back. And then I just pre-drilled everything. And I set my pre-driller with a piece of tape so I wouldn't drill through the panel. Then before I placed the washer and dryer, I put a baseboard in. I siliconed all three sides like I always do. That way water will run out the front. Then I put the washer and dryer in and installed the doors, as you can see. Then the doors needed a really good adjusting and fine tuning before I put those brackets on. And yeah, that's kind of it in a nutshell.
Before we sign off, you guys, you don't actually have to do and match the white on the white. You can mix the colors if you want. If you want to contrast, get this kitchen section one color and then just contrast it to the white. You can do anything you want. We want to just kind of blend into the background. But I hope that gives you guys some ideas and tips and ways you can know you can kind of mix a system, customize it to your own needs. And yeah, don't forget to leave a comment down below if you like the system or if you like my ideas. And the next video, we're going to show you how I cut down a cabinet drawer and we made a makeup drawer unit in our vanity, for our vanity. So that's the next video. But anyway, thanks for tuning in and we'll see you on the next one. And here's a little insider tip. If you guys want to light me up in the comments, I got a little dimple here from putting my brackets on. Rookie mistake, just a hair too long, and I dimpled my door. So you guys feel free to light me up and smash some comments there and bash me just a little bit. It's okay.